My top priority when I moved into my house 6 years ago was to put in a nice lawn. My mom said it probably made more sense to install a dishwasher first, and I have to agree with her, but I haven't always been known to do what makes the most sense. I still haven't installed the dishwasher, dang it. The lawn was a huge job, and it took me the whole summer to install the 100 plus sprinklers, but I was really glad I did it, and I think it turned out really nice. But over this last summer, some areas of my lawn started drying up and dying out. So my lawn irrigation is tied into the big pump out in our field, which is really nice because it has enough flow to run all the sprinklers at once and is comparatively cheap to run. But the downside of doing this, I've learned, is that it pumps a little bit of sand, which isn't a problem for the hand pipe irrigation out in the field, but for my small lawn sprinklers causes a lot of problems. There's about 20 sprinklers that wouldn't pop up anymore, and we're leaving large areas of my lawn unwatered. I've dug them up before and cleaned them out, but they just got plugged up again really quickly, and I wasn't making any progress and was just getting frustrated with it. So I decided to buy a large filter, which is probably what I should have done to begin with, and install it in the line before the first sprinkler. The filter's pretty good size, and I wanted to install it above ground so I could clean it out easily and often throughout the summer. So I decided the game plan would be to dig down and find the 2-inch line coming from the pump, and then cut out a section of it the same width as the filter, and then I would elbow upward from it so I could install the filter in a easily accessible place. This was kind of in a low spot, and there was a lot of water in the pipe still. So while Drake and I waited for it to drain, we had a beer in the tailgate. And sure enough, after we finished that, the water had drained and we were able to start gluing pieces on. I left these new 2-inch pieces of pipe long so I could glue them in place and then cut them off level at the same height after they were glued onto the existing pipe. I just had to be sure to get them straight up and down. The filter had 2-inch male threads on it, so I bought some 90 degree elbows with threads on one side and then the other side was slip so it could go onto the 2-inch pipe that I just installed. I always use a ton of glue on both of the pieces that I'm gluing. Glue is cheap and I think it's just a nice security knowing that you can get good coverage on the fittings. After they were glued, I filled back in the hole and packed it down tight. And then I gave the white PVC a quick shot of black spray paint to make it a little less unsightly. I wanted to build a metal frame to hold the filter steady and to also give a little protection from the tractors in the field next to it. It's pretty easy to accidentally hit something with the wide disc or other implement behind the tractor when you're working ground. I can personally attest to this. So I thought I would set a couple posts in concrete and then have a couple arms come out and fasten onto the filter to hold it securely. I capped off the tubing so it wouldn't fill with rainwater. Once I had that done, I hauled it back to my place to get it into position. Had a bit of a tuning fork effect going on. I dug a couple new holes now for the posts. Ground was a lot softer digging it the second time. Drake has an amazing skill for dropping the ball down the hole that I'm digging in. Somehow he learned that if he drops it down there, then he knows I have to throw it to get it out of the way. I went ahead and clamped the metal bracket onto the filter to help hold it at the right height and in the right position. And then I mixed some concrete. I was hoping 2 bags was enough. It's always kind of hard for me knowing how much I need. And then I wheeled it back over to the holes. I learned from editing this video that my wheelbarrow really needs some oil on the wheel. That's one squeaky wheelbarrow. I almost hit the hole when I poured it in. Did my best to divide it evenly between the two sides. And then I also gave the metal a shot of black spray paint as well. Filter install done. Let's move on to fixing the sprinklers that won't pop up anymore. I turned the water on and went around and marked all the sprinklers that wouldn't pop up anymore. And then I tried to save as much of the grass as possible. Usually you can remove big clumps of the grass and set it aside so you can put it back in place after you're done cleaning out the sprinkler. I usually give the outside of the sprinkler a quick scrub so no more dirt gets inside the sprinkler as you're cleaning it. And then I unscrew the top and pull it apart. Inside here is where all the sand is, which prevents the head of the sprinkler from popping up. There's a tiny filter on the bottom of the inside of the sprinkler that prevents sand and other particles from getting inside the sprinkler, but it doesn't prevent any sand from getting inside the sprinkler housing. Once I have it all cleaned up and it seems like the sprinkler head can move freely and pop up like it should, I put the sprinkler back together and then screw it back onto the fitting in the ground. I pack the dirt back tightly around it and then patch back together the grass that I had set aside. I give it a good stomping down to make sure it's level and dirt's packed tightly. And then that one's good. Just gotta move on to the other ones. I have a lot of dead grass material in my lawn that really makes everything look slightly brown. This material never gets cut because it's obviously the same height as the rest of my lawn when it gets mowed. I wanted to try mowing the lawn down as short as it would go, basically ground level, which I thought would chop up this dead material. And then the new grass would grow back up again, and it would be just the green leaves. I figured doing this would make it look pretty rough for a couple weeks until the new grass grows back, but I hoped it would be worth it in the long run. I kind of like experimenting on my lawn and trying different things. It's probably the same impulse I have that leads me to buzzing my head every couple years. Just gotta try something new every now and then. The boss was out of town, which is always my opportunity to use farm equipment in their unintended ways. I went and grabbed the hazelnut rake to try raking the clippings that I just flailed. And it worked surprisingly well. It's kind of a slow go, but it really cleaned it up nice and put the grass in a row. The lawn was probably 3 inches tall when I flailed it, so there's a lot of material to get raked up. I just kept pushing the rows closer and closer to the edge. I couldn't do it all at once because the rows got too big, but I eventually got it all pushed over in one neat row. I only thatched half my lawn, or is it called dethatching? I'm not sure. I wanted to compare it to an area that wasn't thatched to see what the difference was, trying to be a little scientific about it. But after I got that done, I spread some fertilizer, hoping it would help green it up and encourage some new growth. Probably a little late to be doing all this. I wish I'd been doing it a couple months earlier in the year, but I just get so busy in the summer that I didn't get to it until September. But now all my maintenance is done, and I just had to keep the water going on it for 3 or 4 weeks. This is fescue, which likes less frequent but heavier waterings. So I watered it twice a week for an hour each time. 4 weeks later, the grass was ready to be mowed again. Everything greened up really nice, and I don't think there were any areas that didn't come back from being dried up. The part of the lawn I dethatched took longer than I expected to grow back, I think mostly because the summer is ending and the grass is starting to grow slower. But I was really happy with how it looked eventually. This is the area I mowed flat with the ground. The majority of the dead grass material was gone, and it really made the lawn look greener and healthier. In contrast, this is an area I didn't dethatch, and although the grass is green and growing, the dead stuff really chokes it out and makes it look brown. It seems like one of the downsides of dethatching, though, is it gives the weeds a chance to grow and take over when the grass is short. But you can't have everything, I guess. Hopefully a couple more mowings will help take care of them, or at least set them back a little bit. Although summer has pretty much come to a close, we will still occasionally get a really nice evening this time of year, and Drake and I try to take full advantage of them. And now I get to do that with a nice green lawn. Jackpot!